Breaking news, there was cursing, even death threats inside the homegoing service for three-year-old Maurice Brown Jr. today. Dozens of police officers were called to calm the emotional crowd. It all started when a man made a comment about the boy's father, Maurice Brown Sr., who is charged with killing his son. News Channel 3's Elise Preston has more on what was supposed to be a celebration of life for little Maurice.
Just a few feet long, three-year-old Maurice Brown Jr.'s casket is wheeled inside his funeral Saturday. His mother and other family members line up to see the toddler one last time, a child they affectionately call Junior.
Only God knows the pain that I feel inside when I come down to my son.
Pain after police found the toddler's body tossed in a dumpster, badly beaten, and now his own father, Maurice Brown Sr., is charged with his murder.
But I'm not going to think about nothing but the good memories that I had with Junior.
Bright smile, contagious laugh, always happy and full of merit.
Junior's stepfather could barely hold back tears. His aunt just couldn't find the words to say. But the beautiful service that celebrated the life of a spirited and bashful child.
I told him, Junior, get up, boy. He looked at me and said, Mama, you ain't calling me no big boy.
Was interrupted when a man attending the funeral stated the child was killed by a man who wasn't a good dad.
A little child was born and lost his life from a father, not being a father.
Brown Sr.'s family, so upset, rushed outside the church's sanctuary cursing. The sounds of singing and sniffles were replaced with commotion and chaos. Dozens of Memphis police were able to stop the argument from getting more volatile outside. Inside the church, Brown Jr.'s cousins cried their hearts out.
God is good.
And funeral attendees shook their heads, telling us they were heartbroken for a child killed in violence and now buried in violence.
Waiting, trying to find the child, trying to see what the outcome was.
The service continued minutes later to honor Brown Jr. and his family.
But I know he's in a better place.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And I'm going to see him one day. Oh,
yeah. Elise Preston, WREG News Channel 3.
As a precaution, Memphis police escorted the man whose speech ignited the disturbance off the property.